Dozens of retired generals are calling for the resignation of top military officials following the Afghanistan withdrawal that became a nightmare for everybody left in the country. Farron Cousins from Trial Lawyer Magazine joins me now to talk about this. Strong language. I don't know how language can get any stronger from these generals that said, you really blew it, Milley, you really blew it. Biden, I mean, across the board, it's an attack. They described it as like celebrating the Titanic sinking as the most successful lifeboat rescue in history. What's your take on this story?
Well, look, I mean, there's no question, obviously, and you and I have agreed on this, we needed to be out of Afghanistan 100%. But that doesn't mean that we need to look at all the chaos that happened and said, oh, okay, no, this is a good thing. Milley, Austin with the Secretary of Defense, they were the ones who were supposed to be giving guidance here. They were the ones looking at the intelligence that our agencies have been putting together for 20 years and finally just said, okay, you know what? Go ahead, just pull the trigger now. Just get everybody out. We'll see what happens. It's their job, though. It's their job to give this military advice that clearly did not pan out well.
Part of the criticism is this was done by political decisions on their part.
Yeah.
They didn't want to rock the boat. They were afraid that was going to hurt their political career. And so what you have, the bothersome thing when you really drill down on this, they had 7 months to plan this. Okay, I mean, give Biden the biggest give you can give him. He had 7 months to plan this. You had a bipartisan committee, Republicans, Democrats, who said, you know what, it might take as many as 14 months. But Biden understood that the midterm elections are coming up, and he did this for the midterm elections. He did this so he could go on TV on Tuesday, pat himself on the back, and say, great job. There's no way to escape this. Look, we both agree. We had to get the hell out of there. We never should have been there at all, except for corporate media helped put us there. We'll talk about that in just a minute. But some of these quotes are just strong. I mean, here it is. The consensus of the disaster are enormous, and they're going to reverberate for decades. These generals said the death and torture of Afghans has already begun, and it's going to result in a major human tragedy of major proportions. Another quote by the generals, the loss of billions of dollars in advanced military equipment and supplies falling into the hands of our enemies is catastrophic. Now our adversaries are emboldened to move against America due to the weakness displayed in Afghanistan. Terrorists around the world are emboldened and able to pass freely into our country through open borders on Mexico. I mean, look, we've seen generals attack the White House before. Right. This might be the strongest I've seen. I don't know. Maybe you can recall something else.
Well, in some of, you know, what you were just reading there, that gets in a little bit. Okay, you see the warmongering starting to come out with some of these people.
Okay,
like, because they mentioned, Russia is now going to come. China's going to come. The immigrants are going to come.
Right.
The So, you know, that part, they go a little too far with that. Well, and that is a little bit, you know, it's their job. They get the promotions when they go out and do good in these wars. So there's a little self-preservation.
Moreover, these people are in the war business.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, none of them were happy to get out of Afghanistan.
True.
I mean, you know, most of these folks, these generals that now, a lot of them work for the arms industry. They work for weapons manufacturers. Corporate news puts them up every night, and they sell what it is they want to sell, and that is we need to get back in. Nevertheless, these attacks are brutal attacks.
They are.
I can tell you, I've never seen attacks like this, attacking the White House this strongly. And you know, you can't blame them. I mean, whether they're there to say this because they want to go back in Afghanistan or not, this was a major screw-up that should have been avoided.
Right. And look, right now we are seeing Biden's poll numbers start to dip because of this, and it is directly because of this Afghanistan bungling, even though most people do support the withdrawal. You know, everybody wanted out.
Well, you and I support the withdrawal.
Right. So, honestly, if I'm putting down any partisan blinders and I'm looking at this as a political consultant, what I would be telling Joe Biden right now is make them resign.
You need
a scapegoat.
You need
somebody to shift blame onto for this. And you've already got the public saying, we need answers. So go ahead and do it. These are people, look, they've been around forever. Mm-hmm. They have been involved in multiple different administrations. you know, making bad decisions here and there, doing a couple good things, I will say, Milley has in the past with setting up, you know, kind of modernizing the military a degree, but...
He's called a snowflake, you understand. These are, within the military, they regard him as a snowflake. So now this is another opportunity to attack him. Whether he's a snowflake or not, I don't know. But I can tell you, he's an inept strategist. And well, that's what shows
here. Yeah, I mean, that's given here. And so I do think Biden, it would be in his best interest, I think, to get rid of these people
me
and
too.
Move forward with that.
Yeah, it could help. I mean, it'll help those poll numbers at least.
Yeah.
I mean, today, his speech, I don't know. I don't think it's going to help poll numbers that much. But if you do get rid of the people and you say, look, I was taking advice from them. You know what really gets ugly, though? Milley and Lloyd Austin say it wasn't our fault. It was the fault of the CIA and the NSA because we had bad information. How in the hell do you have bad information when we've been there 20 years?
I mean, you're talking about two organizations. Their job is literally intelligence. And then they come back and say, oh, well, our intelligence was not good. So, okay, your agency is not good.
Yeah, I mean,
Biden could use this if he was a real transformational president. He could use this as the opportunity to tear it all down and build it into something that actually works, that isn't, you know, this big spy agency for American citizens.
Right.
He could change it all right now. He's given that opportunity, but he won't take it
all. I just think that's such an interesting observation. Milley and Austin say, it wasn't our fault. Wasn't the president's fault. It was the NSA and the CIA, the same people who brought us 9/11. Yeah. Interesting. But, you know, at the end of the day, they've accused him of incompetence, negligence, motivated by political pressure and a need to do well politically, reckless disregard for American and Afghan lives in order to please the White House. That's the language that's out there. So I think you're right. I think he needs to get the hell rid of these guys as soon as he can.